And now, from Emu's world, somewhere in the heart of England, comes...
Emu's Pink Windmill Show!
Love is spreading over the world. Put your ear to the ground, you can hear it coming. Love is spreading over the world.
Did you like that?
Yeah.
Were you waving your flag?
Yeah.
Oh, that's lovely. No, don't take that. You hold that because it's time for us to go right over and phone somebody at home and play Emu Spin Quiz, shall we? Oh, here we are, Emu Spin Quiz again. And who have we got to help us today? It's Kelly. Come on in, Kelly. Give Kelly a big cheer. Hello. You all right?
Yes, thank you.
Right, and what we're going to do, we're going to pull out a letter. Oh, first of all, we better tell everybody about some of the super prizes you can win on Spin Quiz today. Wasn't that good?
Yeah.
And what about our star prize?
Star prize!
You can pop for points with this excellent snooker table.
Yeah!
It's going to be good, isn't it, to try with that. Have you got one there, Evie? Thank you very much. Oh, look at this one. I can see it, yes. It's a very nice one. It's from Samantha Ayers, who lives in Portsmouth. And look, if I can just show you that. She's got a pink windmill on there. And she's even got our spin quiz wheel. Look, it goes round, look. Isn't that lovely? And Samantha is 9 1/2. There's her phone number. Okay, right. Kelly.
Yep.
So we're going to be phoning you now, Samantha. Hope you're there. I'll just quickly read what she said. Dear Rod and Emu, I watch your show every week it's on. Oh, that's good. I'm glad that you don't watch it when it's not on. I'd really like you to phone me up because I never have much luck on anything. Oh, well, never mind, Samantha. Perhaps we can do it this time.
Ring in.
And she says, please could you leave the address up a bit longer because I never have time to write it down. Well, we'll do that today. And get your pencils and paper ready now because it'll be coming up at the end of this bit and then you'll be able to get the address and write it down. That's a good idea, actually, isn't it? Leaving the address up a bit longer so as we can write it down. Still talking because I'm waiting for somebody to answer the phone. Are you there, Samantha? No. Oh, dear.
It is out.
Oh, I hope not. If you get, it's no good writing in if you're going to be out, is it? It's best to be in so you can get our phone. I'll tell you, have another quick phone.
Right.
Have another quick dial. Right, that's it. Put it down and I'll help you. That's it. You're doing it. We're doing it right, Samantha. Did you press that one?
Yep.
Oh. Right. She's very good, Kelly. Yeah. Anyway, I stopped doing that. Anyway, as I was saying, when we do get through to you, Samantha, we should ask you a question, and then if you get it right and it's not even phoning at all... Yeah, I knew you'd done it wrong! Let's have another go. I'll press the buttons this time. You talk to the audience.
Oh.
I know what it is. That's it. And that one. And that one. Now, that should be all right, shouldn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
Ta-da! I'll do that bit, not you. Yeah, we're just waiting here for it to go boop again. And then when it goes boop, we'll...
Put the phone down.
It's ringing. Yeah, now we're all right. Yeah. Now, any minute now, she's going to say, hello, this is Samantha. Please.
Hello?
Hello, she's on the phone.
I know it. Yeah. Hello, is that Samantha?
Yes.
Oh, thank goodness we got through to you at last. It's Rod and Emu calling you from the Pink Windmill, all right?
Yeah.
And we've got your letter here. It's a lovely letter. And we're going to go straight on and ask you a question, a 9.5-year-old question.
What will a caterpillar turn into?
What will a caterpillar turn into?
Butterfly.
Yes. A butterfly, yes! Come on! Oh, look! Still, it's on number 20, and I'm sure number 20 is a lovely prize.
It's a clock!
You've won a clock, yes. Samantha, all right! Yes. Got it there? There we are. That's the clock, and that's coming to you. Thank you very much for that, okay. Peter. Thank you very much for playing the game, Samantha.
That's okay.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
Right, and as Samantha said, here's the address to write to, and we'll keep it up for a little bit longer.
Emu's Pink Windmill Show, Central Independent Television, Lenton Lane, Nottingham, NG7, 2NA.
Croc, will you look at this place? No sooner do we get it all nice and tidied up when whoosh, and we're whisked off on another mission to try and capture that emu. Oh, do you know, I can't wait till I go on my holidays.
Oh, me neither, Redford.
Here, I've sent for some brochures. I think I'm going to go to Grotlands and be one of the campers. Oh, those carefree, sun-packed days. Oh, up in the morning, PT, then off to bingo.
Ooh, I'd like to go to the Bahamas myself. Here, Redford, that was the first prize in a competition I entered in 2 months ago.
Oh, Croc, not another one of your tacky competitions. What is it this time?
Well, it was called the Stars and Their Boots Competition. They had all these pictures of very famous TV stars and lots of pictures of boots, and you had to match them up.
What are you two up to? Both of you two, you horrible brats! Be quiet! Redford, that's the postman. You go off and get the mail.
Oh.
And you, when you finish that, you can get the hovergrot ready for our mission. Because I'm going to come down there and I'm going to get you and I'm going to get you. Oh, yes, I am. I'm going to come down there so you lot had better watch out.
Look, I've got my brochures. Look. And there's one for you, Croc.
Ooh.
Well, there's a letter for you, Mrs. Grotbags. By the look of it, it could be from the WI.
Oh,
look at this. Oh, isn't that lovely? Look at that. Oh, that'll be me dashing down to the swimming pool to have a dip before joining the queue for lunch.
Oh, listen to this. I've been asked to be a delegate and speak at the WI conference in Blackpool. Oh, what a honour.
I've won.
Oh, look at this, you see. Look, this is all free, you see. It's all free. All the entertainments and the crazy golf, all free. Oh, do you know, I can feel it calling me now.
I've won.
Oh, imagine me, speaking at the conference in Blackpool. Oh, it'll be so important. You stay at the Imperial, then you come down for breakfast, and then you're interviewed by all those television people.
I've won.
And then, of course, you've got the conference itself. Oh, what are you talking about? What have you won?
I've won a trip to the Bahamas.
Congratulations for being the outright winner in the Stars and Their Boots competition.
You have won a trip to the Bahamas for two? For two? Oh, I've always wanted to go to the Bahamas.
Oh, what's happened to Blackpool all of a sudden, eh? Here, don't you take any notice of her, Croc. You do whatever you want to do. You take whomsoever you wish, someone like your bestest friend. And I can always go to Grotlin's next year.
Now, my clever little Croc for winning that competition, what would you like to do?
Well, I thought we were going on a mission.
What? And have you up there on that drafty hovergrot? I wouldn't dream of it, Croc. You just rest.
Oh, yes, and I'll make you a nice cup of tea, Croc.
Oh, no, you won't. I'll make the tea. That's just despicable of you, that is. All you want to do is share Croc's well-deserved prize. That's terrible.
Oh, and what about you? One minute you're going to be speaking at Blackpool, and then the next minute you've got your sunglasses packed for a trip to the Bahamas.
Oh, that's very personal. Take that. Oh, that's really awful. How dare you accuse me of such a low-down, rotten trick? And what about you and your stupid holiday camp, eh?
That's got nothing to do with it. That hasn't.
That's got nothing to
no,
do with it.
No, it hasn't.
Oh, I can see through your little game. I've just about...
Excuse me. I think I'll go for a little walk.
Oh, yes, Croc, that's right. You go for a little walk. As a matter of fact, I think I'll join you. Just in case he needs a helping hand.
Redford! You come back here at once, Redford! Come back here, you crawling, scraping, animated sea ant! Ooh! And I've not finished with you yet. I hate brats, especially horrible kids. I'm gonna come down there and I'm gonna get you and I'll get that in you. Yeah. Oh yes, I will. But first, my trip to the Bahamas. Now, Croc, where are you? Would you like a blanket? I don't want you catching a chill, Croc.
Pictures have been coming through that on the minute. Amy's just looking for pictures on our special pink link, which is our link to Australia, because any minute we'll be getting another report from Trina, who's down there at yet another school. But meanwhile, I'll just quickly tell you about a school that we showed you, what was it, 2 weeks ago? That was Deniston East, and that was at a place called Eastwood out in Australia. And we're very happy to announce that they've been twinned with the Chantry Junior School at Luton in Bedfordshire. And there you can see some of the pupils. They're in the school, and soon they'll be writing to their twins out in Australia and hopefully carry on writing for years and years to come. Here, look, we got pictures. Oh, I wonder where we are. I can't see. Where are we? Trina, where are you? Over.
Today we're at the North Sydney Demonstration School, and this is Miss Hoadley. Miss Hoadley, how many children do you have at the school?
We have 600.
And what are their age ranges?
Well, they go from kindergarten, that's 5, up to year 6, and they might be 12, 11 or 12.
Right. I notice how bright the classrooms are. They're really, you know, bright and colourful. Does this play a big part in the school?
Yes, they look super, don't they? It's all the school classrooms like this. You see, our school's rather unusual because as a demonstration school, we're affiliated with Sydney University and we demonstrate teaching techniques.
So that's why it's called a demonstration school then?
Yeah, we demonstrate teaching ideas to students and also to visitors and people that come around too.
Uh-huh. And you have a computer program here, is that right? very young age to start computers.
Yes, we do. We have a computer program that all the children take part in right from kindergarten, and they look amazingly cute working on computers. And it covers all subject areas, and every child has hands-on experience every week.
Aren't they cute? See you next week, Rod. Bye.
Oh, isn't that lovely? And what a lovely school. All that colour everywhere. And they're obviously into dance and drama and computers. Well, if you've got a school like that and you are about 600 pupils and your ages range between 5 and 12, then why not have a chat with your headmaster in your class and drop us a line and maybe we can twin you with that school. We'll be giving you the address, of course, later on in our Pink Windmill programme. But right now, it's time to leave the Pink Windmill and go to another part of Emu's world, that part that's governed by my ancestors. And as we heard last week, it's got Grotbags' ancestor as well.
Early morning in Boggle's kingdom, and with Dr. John on army manoeuvres, Prince Paulie fast asleep, Princess Hortensia is awaiting the outcome of a spell that will free her brother. What, John?
Any news yet?
Shh.
Oh, poor Boggle. He's been standing under the oak tree at Bottom Pond all night, holding that twig.
He must stay there right until the first drops of dew fall from the oak leaves onto the orn beam.
Oh, poor Boggle.
Oh, my foot's going to sleep.
Don't he move?
Sorry.
You are on a magic spot. Do not move until you receive the amulet.
I will not move from this spot till I receive the armalite.
Amulet, you fool.
Amulet, you fool.
And now the time has come. Between the last shriek of the night owl and the first crow of the cock, it's time to command the powers of the amulet.
Oh, dear.
Mystic powers that lies in wait. It's Ada calling. Can you hear me, mate? It's working. It be working.
What's happening now?
He'd been commanded to take the amulet to Boggle.
What then?
They throw it away and the spell be broken.
Oh, good. Will it work?
Only if he gets to Boggle before the cock crows for the third time. And if Boggle don't move from that spot.
Wait, men. That was the first crow of the cock. It's time to be moving, men, to make our assault on Dreamy Village. Come on, Blue Force.
Here. Just a minute, Odd Job John. Look. There's the commander of the Red Force.
Why, so it is. It's His Majesty. Yeah. Look at him trying to hide behind that twig.
Shh.
Come on, quietly now.
Oh, second one. Only one more to go. Grab him, men! Don't move me! Don't move me! No! I've got to wait here till the cock crows for the third time!
Ah, no! Is that your password, Your Majesty? You've just been captured by Blue Force! Take him away, men!
Oh, no, no, no! The stupid twit! He's got to move from the spot! Get back, get back! He's got to be there before the cock crows for the third time!
Oh, Boggle! Get back on that spot at once! Do you hear?
Stop! Oh, John, I must be back on that spot before the cock crows for the third time. No, I really must, please.
Do as he says, men.
Quick as you can, quick! Oh, quick!
Witchcraft!
There it is. It be all done, all finished.
Oh, thank you, Ada. You must let me pay you for your services.
Oh, no. I've received a handsome payment. I've perpetuated my witchcraft for centuries to come. There will always be a witch living somewhere near Boggle's kingdom. Right then, I'll be off. Back to me forest. I don't like houses much.
Always be a witch living somewhere near Boggle's kingdom? Oh, well, that's in the far future. I can't worry about that now. Oh, Boggle, you're back! Are you safe?
Oh, I've felt better, you know, my dear. And jolly good army maneuvers they were. Mind you, old Paulie didn't like it very much.
Standing in the dew I was, with hardly any clothes on. Oh, I've got the most dreadful chill. Oh, and it's brought on the palpitations and the vapours.
Oh, never mind, Paulie. We'll get you right before we take you home tomorrow.
Tomorrow? I seem to recall Boggle saying I could stay for 2 whole weeks. Yes, yes. Well, I might feel just a little better by then. Oh, take me to my room and don't drop me. Oh, all the blood.
Welcome back. Here, there's somebody at the door. Oh, there's somebody at the door.
Oh, there's somebody at the door.
Oh, there's somebody at the door.
Oh, there's somebody at the door.
Oh, there's somebody
at the door.
Oh, it's the postman. Come on in, postman. How are you?
Good afternoon, Mr. Howe.
Good afternoon.
Oh, cheap joy for Emu, lovely little birdie. Joyful.
Oh, how lovely. Yes. What have you got for us then?
Well, I've got some brochures here for the children.
Oh, thank you. One for...
Oh, yes, right. Oh, brochures.
Choosy joy for your holiday. And deep joy paddling in the sand and no ice cream in the gritty.
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir, but you talking like that. Have you got a brother who works for British Telecom? Because he was here a couple of weeks ago over at a Pink Windmill doing...
Yeah, with your rotating windmill of the music. Yeah, I remember. That's my elder brother. He speaks very good English.
Does he really?
Yes.
Oh,
I speak the basic English 25, though.
But, yes.
Because general post officer. Now, Mr. Hull, your holiday special. Yeah,
yes.
What's your interest?
Well, have you got, okay.
I've got a brochure.
Brochure for the holiday. Well, Emu would like to go on a holiday, wouldn't you? He'd like to go skiing.
Yeah, but just a mode. You say skiing for Emu?
Yes.
Well, there's a problem here. Because, you see, where the avalanche between the anvil's full of over your head load, your leather's so thin, a tawny caper, so crackling, fall down, Oh, folly. Just for that out. That's out.
Does that mean that you can't go?
Not for skiing, no.
Not for skiing?
No, mountainous thought.
No. Well, what about, windsurfing?
Oh, wait a minute, windsurfing.
Yeah, if you go windsurfing.
Windsurfing?
Like so.
There's a prop load here on account of where the side wind and Emu's small wings, so the wind suddenly half a load and splosh it out of the port and star pole. Never worked.
Really?
No, I'm afraid not.
You can't go windsurfing. No. Well, what about golf?
Well, golf. Now, let's have a look. Gleneagle load through, Carnoustie, Hoostie, Froostie. That's the focus.
Oh, is that?
I've a little in front of you. You see, you'll never do a bogey through up the fairway and frisk it there.
No.
You see, the bunker holder, half load out. I'll tell you what, though, there's no joy here.
You really can't go on any holidays at all?
Well, with regard to golf, you see, there's the birdies. Now, that doesn't embrace a human hole. Oh, no. And there's an eagle, which is a 200 par load Thorcus, and an albatross. There's no place for Emu, I'm afraid, on a golf holiday.
Hey, stop it. Will you stop it?
I'll tell the postmaster general. There's only one per family.
Oh, sorry.
And this week we've received drawings from Michael McKay, William Minty, Rachel Scantlebury, Kathy Shivnan, Samin Patel,
Mark Lauder, Michelle Love, Andrew Ways, Lynn Davis, and Lee Hutchinson.
And we've got this striking picture done in all different colour walls. It's been put on a black background as well. And that was sent in to us by Lydia Boundy, and she's aged almost 7, from Leicestershire. Thanks very much for that, Lydia.
And I've got a woolly picture here, and it was sent in from a mum who watches, you see. And it was sent with this lovely letter here, and it's from Donna Simerson, age 6, from Eastwood, who writes, "Dear Pink Windmill Post Office, I watch each week and ask my mummy to knit a picture to show on your post office. Well, thanks very much, Donna, and Donna's mum. We'll be sending you a Pink Windmill T-shirt, although I don't think this is going to fit Donna's mum, actually. I think it's a bit small. Mm. Well, thanks to you anyway.
Yeah, as you all know, the senders of the letters that we read out on the post office will be receiving a Pink Windmill T-shirt, and there'll be one on the way to you, Lucy Osler, from Paul in Dorset, for this. See? It's a door there, and it's got rat-a-tat-tat on it. And when you open it up, there's Emu saying, there's somebody at the door.
That's really good. Well, I've got a card here, and it's really lovely. And it's from Julie Rawley, aged 13. And she writes, Dear Rod and Emu, could you please make my dreams come true? I would love you to come and help feed the animals on my cousin's farm.
Mm. So Rod and Emu went down to the farm, met Julie, and met all the animals.
You obviously like animals, don't you, Julie? Yeah, well, actually, Julie's invited us down to feed all the animals on the farm. I thought we'd just spend a nice day walking around feeding the animals.
Right.
Shall we do that? Emu wants to do that as well. So would you like to lead the way?
Right.
Come on, then. No, don't eat all that. It's not yours, is it? It belongs to that turkey. Here we are. Look, we've got some, breakfast for you. Here we are. Excuse me. Do you want some as well? Oh, it's good, isn't it? Are you having some as well, handlebars? Come on, then. That's nice, isn't it? Are you watching, Julie?
Yeah.
I'm supposed to be giving this to the chickens. Yes, aren't we, Julie?
Yeah.
I don't want to. Hey, look, it's here. Look, here it is. Excuse me. Look. Ah. He's nice, isn't he?
Diggle, diggle, diggle.
Ow, isn't that lovely? Ow, did you understand that? There's food in here. Here we are. Look, wait a minute. Leave some for Emu. Oh, isn't that nice? Emu? Where are you? Hey! Emu! Emu, come here! Hey, come on, it's time to go! Hey, Emu! Come on, it's time to go! Have you seen Emu anywhere? Oi! Emu!
Okay, he's gone.
And since that recording, we've had another little card from Julie, and it's saying thanks to Rod and Emu for going down to the farm on them, and it also wishes us good luck with the show. So thanks for that, Julie. That's really nice.
Oh, we've also had another card, Joe, but this one's an Easter card, wishing everyone here a happy Easter. And it's from Claire Trooper. So thanks very much, Claire. Mm.
Oh, and that reminds me, there'll be no Pink Windmill show next week because it's Good Friday. And there's a fresh new lineup of programmes on that day on ITV. But be watching on the Saturday morning because that's when the Emu's World Easter special will be on.
So, there you have it. And if you want to drop us a line at Pink Windmill Post Office, the address is...
Emu's Pink Windmill Show, Central Independent Television, Lenton Lane, Nottingham, NG72NA.
Cooey! I'm back! And I've decided what I'm going to do. Well, you see, I've always wanted to go to the Bahamas, and since I could only take one, I didn't know what to do. I mean, Redford, you are my dearest friend, and you're always there to help me. But if I took you, then it wouldn't be fair to Mrs. Grotbags, would it? And then, you see, because Mrs. Grotbags, she deserves to go to the Bahamas. But then it wouldn't be fair to Redford. You see what I mean? If I
had... Oh, Croc, will you stop waffling on? What have you decided to do?
Well, I've sent the prize back and I've asked for the second prize because three people can share the second prize.
Oh, I think that's very fair, don't you, Redford?
Oh, yes. I mean, to take a prize that we can all share, Croc. That's very kind of you.
Mind you, it's probably not so good as the first prize. It won't be as far as the Bahamas.
No.
No, probably something like the Canary Islands.
Oh. The south of France.
Oh. Isle of Wight?
No, it's nowhere at all. The second prize, you see, is three pairs of boots.
Three pairs of boots?
Ooh, well, you remember the prize was called the Stars and Their Boots Competition. Well, the first prize was a trip to the Bahamas, and the second prize was three pairs of boots. So we can all have a pair each. There, you see?
A pair of boots? Oh, don't. Oh, Croc. Oh, I think I'm going to faint.
Oh. You stupid oaf! Oh. Take that! Oh. Bang goes my trip to the Bahamas. Oh. Take that! How dare you! A pair of boots! Take that! Oh. And be quiet, you horrible little brats, because I haven't forgotten about you. I'm going to take it out on them brats. I'm going to beam three of them up for my grotto game. And do you know what I'm going to do if they win?
No, what you going to do?
I'm going to give you the boot.
Oh.
Now, come on, hurry up and get yourself up. That one there. Oh, they're going to be in for it when they get there. And I'll have that one there. They should be at my grotto now waiting for play my game. Grotty's Grotto, the game everybody loves. And may we introduce today our fabulous MD, who has got a new electronic piano. Yes, and now all he has to do is learn to play it. Campbell! Lovely, brother. He's getting better, you know. And here we have our contestants. My hostess with the mostess. And of course, Redford. Now, Redford, will you explain the game?
Yes. Well, we've got one of Mrs. Grotbag's yucky games this week because it all concerns water. You see, what you've got here, you've got a bowl of balls floating in water and you've got a plastic spoon. And what you've got to do is put the spoon in your mouth and pick up the balls and drop them into that bowl there. But when you've put the spoon in your mouth so there's no cheating, you've got to put your hands behind your back. All right? So, I'll put the spoon back there. That's it. You come and stand
And you be very careful, Redford.
Why?
Because if you get the water in your gyroscopic, she'll go like her, Rusty.
Oh, I will. Yes, I have to watch that. All right? You stand
come round here,
there.
Rusty. That's it.
Ready?
And pick up. And I want no cheating or else.
So.
Right? Croc, are you ready to start the game?
Yes.
Pick up your spoons. I'll allow you to do that.
Put them in your mouth.
Put them in your mouth.
And hands behind your back.
Hand behind. Oh, that's good. Ready? Don't forget to breathe. 3, 2, 1.
And who has 3, 4?
Oh, we've got a tiebreaker. Now we've got 4 and 4.
No, she hasn't got hers out. They're in there.
Oh, they're in the wrong bowl, aren't they, Redford?
It's him. He's fun.
Naughty, naughty Grotty.
All right.
You are the winner.
You can put your spoon down.
And come round here. And here we have something really exciting because we have the consolation prizes.
All right. Let Croc give you his consolation.
Now you come here and talk to me.
Hello.
Ta-da, brats!
Bye-bye.
I don't know why we allow him in here, horrible
exciting,
brats. And before we start, I would like to broadcast to the nation and say I've had a postcard from dear Sybil.
Oh.
I know where she is. Oh. She's on holiday in the Virgin Islands. Oh. And she's having lots of fun with Pat and Joe. Isn't that lovely?
Oh, that's lovely.
I've been so worried about her. She's been lost for weeks, yes. You know. Mm. We've lost, we know where she is. Yes. Croc, show the cauldrons!
Ta-da! Well, hello, boys and girls. And look at me. I'd like to
Croc,
introduce...
just one moment, Croc.
What?
Campbell is doing the musical effects.
Oh, I'm sure.
We do not need you to go to Dan.
Well, I'm going a bit deaf. I couldn't hear it.
That's all right, Croc. Carry on. And what is that thing you've got in your hand there?
This is my new friend, Mike. Microphone.
Get on with it, Croc. Show the cauldrons.
Well, you see, we have two cauldrons. And in one of the cauldrons, we have a star prize. And in another cauldron, we have a boobity-boop-boop-booby prize.
Prize?
I don't think he's well.
He's getting worse. We'll have to put him in a zoo. Right. Brat, what is your name, Brat?
Tell me if you've got
that. Speak to me.
Jonathan,
right. You've got two cauldrons.
Right. Number two or number four? What are you going to pick?
Hurry up! We haven't got all day!
Number four. Go and get number four, then. I'll bring it to Mrs. That's right. Now, while she's looking in there, we're going to show the boys and girls at home what's in there. Right. We're ready.
Now, instead of that cauldron, what you have already won, I am prepared to offer you something really fantastic. I've got this marvellous thing in here. Oh! Your own croquet set. Isn't that amazing?
That's Landero plane.
And of course, I have here some Travel Connect 4, which is a strategy game. Do you like? No, you don't like them, do you? Oh! A gun and Streaky Bonehead's book. And an emu spinner! Oh, that's your cauldron.
What are you going
quickly
to do?
Quickly! Those. Cauldron. Pardon? Are you certain you want to take the cauldron? Do you know what you've won? A plate of semolina!
Oh. Take your semolina. Go to the cauldron.
Today.
No, it
wasn't, Danny. Kelly, what did you do? You're still reading the holiday.
Sorry, brother. I was choosing where I want to go for my holiday.
Well, we haven't. We've got to do the spin quiz, because it's time, in fact, back here in the Pink Windmill to have another go on the spin quiz. And we'll have a quick look and see what we've got. Oh, this one's come all the way from Guernsey in the Channel Islands. And it's Carla Lepage. And there's the phone number. Right. Would you like to phone her up? And she says, please, if you can't phone me, then can you read my poem out on the post office spot and say hello to my brother Brian and my sister Paula? Well, we will, but I hope we're going to try and get through to you so we can speak to you, Carla. It's nice getting letters all the way from the Channel Islands, isn't it? From Guernsey. In fact, we should be going there in the summer. So we might see you, because Emu and Grotbags and I are going to go over there and do a show. So we'll probably see you in Guernsey.
Hello? Who's that?
Who's that? It's a continental phone call. Hello, is that Carla? This is Rod and Emu calling you from the Pink Windmill.
Yes. Yeah.
Is that you?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, how lovely to hear you. What's it like over there?
Cold.
Cold, all right. We're going to ask you a question, Carla.
Right. How many years in a decade?
How many years in a decade?
10.
10! Yeah. Yes! Come on! Oh. Well, it wasn't quite the star prize, but we've got a nice prize for you.
It's a travelling hairdryer.
It's a travelling hairdryer. All right, Carla. Where is it? Got it over here.
Thank you very much,
Carla. Bye.
Bye.
There we are. Would you like to go and get that sent off from the Pink Windmill post office? Where's that Kelly gone? I bet she's reading those holiday brochures again. It's always we're supposed to be doing the Pink Windmill, and they're all doing the holiday brochures.
All night holiday, all night holiday, all night holiday, all night holiday. Let me take you somewhere you will not forget. Somewhere you. Say you've seen the
instrument sound up, let the music flow.
Friday, but we'll be there on Saturday morning with Emu's Easter special.
What a great finish to a great Friday afternoon. My thanks to Mr. Shoji for